Hey guys, I once again welcome you to my channel. So in today's video, I am going to show you the proper way that how you can report your sensitive areas and also how you can propagate your sensitive areas in very easy steps. This is the sensitive area trifasciata, or this is the sensitive area laurenti. So this is the common variety of sensitive area, or commonly known as snake plant. This plant is the easiest and the common one which you can easily find in any nursery. Talking about the leaves, you can see that it have got green leaves which have light green-gray cross banding. This is the most durable and hardiest plant that you can easily grow if you are beginner in indoor plant gardening. This plant can also tolerate low light conditions as well as drought tolerant. A study by NASA found that it is one of the best plant for improving your indoor air quality. This plant can remove xylene, toluene, formaldehyde, nitrogen oxides from your indoors as well. I have made a separate video regarding this plant odor care. So if you are interested to see that video, I will give that video link in the description box. I really like to thank all my new subscribers, and I really request those viewers who haven't subscribed to my channel yet. So the process of repotting of this plant and getting new plants from this plant is very easy. Much before starting this repotting process, you have to keep in mind three things. That the first thing is whether your plant is ready to be repotted, that you can find by easily see your pot. If you see that most of the roots are coming bottom of the pot, in that condition your plant really needs the repotting. The second most important thing is, much before starting this repotting process, keep that plant dried out for at least 3 to 4 days. After that, start your repotting process. Next thing is, without damaging your roots as much as possible, how to repot it properly and what kind of soil mixture you should use. So if you let your pot to be dried out for at least 3 to 4 days, you can easily separate the soil mixture from the roots. You can see here that I have kept this plant in the plastic container. So the first process is to remove the top layer of the soil. You can do that very easily. I am using my bare hands, but you can also do it some kind of gardening tools. I have used the plastic container, so I am lightly squeezing the sides of the pot so that the soil will eventually get loosened up. You can see that my plant is out of the pot, and you can see there are several bulbs and it have got beautiful roots. So at present, I am not separating the pups from its mother plant because I really like my plants to get on the dense side. So here you can see two pups which can be separated very easily through cuttings, and each have got beautiful roots. So so these plants are very easy to get propagated. So the soil mixture that I usually use for my sensitive areas or snake plants is a mixture of cocopit, perlite, river sand and also vermicompost. If you want, you can also add garden soil to your soil mixture. So these plants are very low feeder of fertilizer, so you can also fertilize your plant at least twice or thrice in 1 month. I use NPK sometimes, and also I use vermicompost in its soil mixture. Rather than separating the pups from its mother plant to get a new plant, you can also propagate this plant through leaf cuttings. I haven't tried those methods because I think that I'm gonna fail. So I use this process to get new pups. That's all for today's video. If you like this video, give this video a big like, share this video, and also kindly please subscribe to my channel. Thanks for watching. Bye.